All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Exotic Astrology. Great to see you back. And today I'm again honored to have Anuradha ji on my channel. So today she will be speaking on the horses. Yes, yes, Ashwini is the topic. And today she's going to make this presentation. I hope I will upload it in 2-3 parts, whichever it is. So please stay tuned till the end. And she also has an ebook. She just said to me, all you want to know about Pushya, that's the name. So I will pin the link in the description. Do you have some link or something for that?
Yeah, I do. Thank you so much, Babaji, for inviting me all over again. I do have a link about that book of mine. It's all that you want to know about Pushya Nakshatra in particular. That's an ebook.
Okay, very nice. So today she will share the presentation on Ashwini Nakshatra, and today moon is also in Ashwini. All right, so please tell us what you want to share.
So I would like to talk about Ashwini Kumaras, a very, very beautiful nakshatra, because it is always ready to help people, and not just help people, it is ready to help people in need as soon as possible, as soon as they are called upon. So these two nakshatra devatas are the part of Ashwini Nakshatra. They are known as Natsya and Tasra. They are the twins. They are born of Vishwavat and Sanjana. Vishwavat is one of the 12 children of Aditi, and he is one of the 12 Suryas, the Adityas. This star, the stars associated with Ashwini, is Alpha Aratus, Beta Aratus, and Gamma Aratus. Okay, and it is also called the star of transport. Ashwini Kumars have a chariot which is a golden chariot. Okay, so before I begin, I would also like to say that such people are very fond of cars, very fond of speedy things, and also they are also fond of gold.
Okay,
so if anybody has a planet, key planet in Ashwini, you can see that people relating to that planet for them, or they themselves can show an affinity for gold. We'll check this out in an example also as we move. Ashwini Kumars are golden armored horse-headed twins. As you can see here, and the symbol of this, you know, the symbol of the Deity, Ashwini Kumars, they're horse-headed. Okay, so they have certain facilities that the horse head has, shows that they're very much strong in the Ashwini Kumars, and they resonate with the person who has a planet in Ashwini. They are the physicians of the god, the friends of the sick and the unfortunate. This is a beautiful star, for it has a lot of healing abilities, because they're the god, healers of physicians of the god. And it is also so that because they rush to anybody's aid, anybody who calls them, especially the one who is downtrodden, who's sick, who's unfortunate, if they call the Ashwini Kumars with a lot of love and affection, then these Kumaras, like the children that they are, get very easily pleased and they come. There is a Beej Mantra associated with all nakshatras, but I generally do not, you know, I'm not in the favor of everybody reciting the Beej Mantras, for the very fact that Beej Mantras are very potent, extremely potent. So if they are not done in guidance under a guru, you know, you read somewhere and you say, okay, I will do this so that I get benefits like that. But since you do not know the underlying effects, side effects, you might also be hit the wrong way. So the best part would be to, in a very honest, in a very pure heart, just, you know, stand up, call upon them, and just tell them that this is the problem I'm facing. Like today is the Ashwini Nakshatra. So on an Ashwini Nakshatra day, or if you're talking about Satabhisha, you're talking about getting well, unwell, then if you do it on that particular Nakshatra day, then it makes a lot of difference, because those devatas do come to help you.
This is very true, because I have a grandmother. She is 86 now, I guess, and she had to undergo an operation when I was in Guwahati on February, and doctors were very scared that will it be successful or not. But then it was so surprising that they gave a date, and I was checking the nakshatra. It was exactly Ashwini, and then I told to my mother, "You don't worry, it will be successful." And the doctors were like amazed how it was successful, because she's very aged, but somehow it happened. All blessings of Ashwini Kumar's.
Yes, so the nakshatra in which you do a surgery, they are the blessed surgeons also. So they have the healing power. There are a lot of nakshatras which have a healing power, and Ashwini is one of them. So the Puranas relate to two Ashwini Kumars as Dasara and Natsya. So these are the names that are given to the Ashwini Kumaras. And association with them, because they're twins, a lot of association of things happening in twos or threes for you, because they're three stars. So you might just have two names. Somebody having a planet in Ashwini might have two names. Somebody might be doing, if you have your 10th Lord, you might have two professions. You know, that way. They scale the sky, showering the healing energies on the earth plane. So when they're moving from one place to another and you're calling them, the above you, right there, blessing you, giving aid to you. Also, we have a connection with the Ashwini Kumars here in, Mahabharata. We see that Ashwini Kumars blessed the second wife of Pandu, Madri, with their love, affection, and also blessed her with the two children from part of themselves, Nakul and Sahadev. And they were known to have a control over horses.
Yeah, yes, perfect.
And cattle. And they were ace physicians. They could heal anything on the planet, be it men, be it beast, be it animals. Any animal, any beast, any man, they could heal. They also had, Nakul in particular, knew, Sahadev, I believe, in particular knew astrology like nobody else on that planet. Like nobody else.
Sahadev it was.
Yes. Sahadev had the ability. And he was the one who predicted that if this happens, because Duryodhan knew how, that Sahadev is an ace astrologer and whatever he tells comes true. So Duryodhan went and asked him, and then Sahadev, because he had to be impartial as an astrologer, told him that if in Abhijita you start the war, you will win.
Okay.
But Krishna did something that Abhijita Nakshatra could not. So but that's a different story. But Sahadev was also a very good astrologer. So these people having key planets in Ashwini Nakshatra also have the ability to gather occult signs. Okay. So let's move on to the power, the Shakti of this Nakshatra is Shidriyapani Shakti. That means to reach things quickly and to attain one's objective. So if you see, typically a person who has a planet in Ashwini Nakshatra, they have the ability to just think, and then they just move around doing their things, and they, because it's also a very quick nakshatra, it's a Shigra Nakshatra, so they are very swift in doing things, and they have healing therapies, they have the ability to be, you know, their hearing sense of hearing is very, very strong. Horses have a very keen sense of hearing and sight. So these people also have a very keen sense of hearing and sight. Now let's take a look at the chart of Florence Nightingale. Florence Nightingale's chart here, it's a Mercury, which is the Lagna Lord and the 10th Lord, sitting in the 8th house. Now, we all know who Florence Nightingale was. She was one of the, that she was called the lady with the lamp. You know, she would travel and see that people are, all those doctors are, not doctors, sorry, all the soldiers in the war were needing a lot of love, care, affection, and she provided that love, care, and affection. And she came from a very good family. Her parents really didn't want to move in, ask her, or did not want her to move into this, you know, profession of healing. But that was a calling, if you see, because Mercury, which is the 10th Lord and the Lagna Lord. Okay, it's in the eighth house of dying, death, sickness, and all those things. And Mercury also is the art of learning. So in this house, it gives her the ability to work with the sick as a profession, as selfless service that she did. And she was the first one to establish the first nursing school in London in 1860. So far as 1860, you know, so.
Yeah, this 9th lord in 10th can also give those flavors.
Yes. So she was that because that's also about compassion, honesty, truth becoming a part of your work and job. So that's a thing. But she has done, and you can see also the sun, which is the 12th lord, has gone into her 9th house again. You know, selfless service into hospitals and nursings, going into the 9th house. So truth, care, all those things.
And this is like perfect. Lagna Lord, 10th Lord, both are in the same because it's the same planet. Fantastic.
Yeah. So, you know, we are all, we do have a lot of things destined for us. Not that we don't understand, but if we do our chart reading properly, we can find out as to what our path's supposed to be. Now, Pamela Anderson, she's worked in we all know her from Baywatch. She is an actress. We all know her from Baywatch. And we know that she's worked in healing as a lifeguard in Baywatch. And she's rescued a number of people. Then she's worked as an emergency services with ambulances and lifeguards and everything. Now, Moon, it is the Karaka for TV and films, is with the Karaka of TV and films itself. Rahu is also about illusion and showbiz. And Moon and Rahu are together in this nakshatra. So showbiz is part of it. But what others should also know, that she is a vocal personality as far as PETA is concerned. Very vocal about animal rights. So she gets that also, that compassion, that moral, and that fortitude, that Moon as a second lord shows, you know, in the 11th house from this nakshatra also, apart from Ardra nakshatra that we will see later sometime. So, and is aspected by the 6th and the 11th lord again, because this Moon and Rahu also become very strong because it is aspected by the 6th lord and the Ketu, which is the Nakshatra Lord.
Ah, okay. Ashwini.
Yes. And Mars is also the 11th Lord. Mars is also the 6th Lord of healing, 6th Lord of doctors.
Oh, okay.
So thing of the world, the need to help others, the need to get through to, you know, others being healed becomes